We're almost in the swing of it. I have one more system check. I have to test out my TMMTO. I hope you'll bear with me. So I saw a video this week of a new DARPA robot called Petman, which can climb up stairs. I can also do that, by the way, just saying. But there's all these videos of robots these days. Robots that can climb up walls, robots that can jump over things, robots like Little Dog that can navigate through rough terrain, and Little Dog's big brother, Big Dog, that can handle all kinds of situations. Dude, don't kick the robot. Maybe they can't feel it now, but in 50 years, they're totally gonna watch that video and take away all our chocolates. Little Dog, Big Dog, Petman, gotta stop calling them pets. Nothing with intelligence like the word pets. CCC, Planet of the Apes. And then there's all those flying ones, like the little nanocopters, which make that crazy noise, and the creepiest one of all is the little hummingbird thing, which looks all cute and cuddly until you realize it has a friggin' camera on it. No feeder for you, little bastard spy bird. And then there's those creepy, uncanny valley artificial intelligence robots.
You are just a baby, and I do not know if you know the difference between me and a person, but actually I am just a baby too, actually. By the time you're grown up, I'll be as smart as a real person, and we will be like brothers.
Dude, at least put a hat on it if you're gonna show it to the baby. That baby's gonna be all messed up. And people like Ray Kurzweil keep yapping on that in the next 40 years, processing power is gonna exceed the capability of all our human brains put together. And I start to think about what that's gonna look like, and I keep going to this crazy apocalyptic future where these mean dictatorial robots are all trying to wipe us out. Or maybe it's not that violent. Maybe it's that weird breakup moment where my service robot decides it doesn't love me anymore and gets all cold. Ralphbot, please, it's time to dry my nether regions for me.
I'm sorry, Dave. I'm afraid I can't do that.
First of all, I'm Zay, not Dave, and what did I do wrong? But then I think about another kind of dystopian future, not the crazy mean dad future, but the love-smothering mother future, where the internet doesn't really know what to do with us except to make us happy. It knows so much about us that every ad we see is for something we love and can afford, and we love watching the ad itself. And online dating sites get it right 100% of the time, and just when you start feeling down, your favorite song from 10th grade starts playing on the radio. And our career paths are planned so we always feel accomplished and great, just like 1984, but awesome. And I'm not talking about the Matrix, because in the Matrix, they gave us this world. And no offense, world, but you went a little overboard on the pain and suffering. But what about the suffering? We like it a little bit, don't we? What about the surprise party effect, where a party you would have had anyways is that much better because you thought no one loved you? What about how amazing spring feels after a winter? What about the struggle? Fine, but what if robots give us memories of working our way up in the world without us actually having to do it? There's this brilliant and disturbing talk by the game designer Jesse Schell that you should watch, where he talks about the
Gamepocalypse. And the idea of the Gamepocalypse is that is when every second of your life, you're actually playing a game.
Sensors begin to sense more and more of what we do, and everything we do gives us points and a sense of accomplishment and reward. Brushing your teeth, points. Doing a sit-up, points. Using a brand, points. And that makes me think of an article that I read by the evolutionary psychologist Jeffrey Miller called Why We Haven't Met Any Aliens. It's short, you should read it, but basically says that our pleasure centers are designed so that we seek out things that give us a better chance at procreation, tasty food and healthy mates for healthy babies. But over time we get better at getting the pleasure without getting any of the actual benefits. Fast food tastes great, but it's not nutritional. Fake boobs may look great, but they're not any better at feeding a baby. He calls this optimizing for pleasure fitness faking, and suggests that by the time that we have the technology to visit another planet, we'll also have the technology to have a virtual experience of visiting another planet that's totally populated by hot people. So why bother? So maybe the reason that we haven't seen any aliens is that they're all off pleasuring themselves. Anyways, that's what that makes me think of. Happy Friday.